Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fit and fine. So dear students, as you all are aware that we are reading chapter 1, The Summer of the Beautiful White Horse, written by William Saroyan. So let us first recall what we have read in this lesson as of now. Then I will explain a few more pages, and today I think we will finish this lesson. So as we have seen, this story which we are reading, it is about two Armenian boys. This story which we are reading, it is about two Armenian boys. They belong to Armenian tribes. Armenian tribe after World War I, they lost their homeland and the whole tribe became homeless. They became very poor. Now they are the victim of extreme poverty. But even though this tribe is famous for their honesty, they were poor, though they were honest in the lesson which we have read as of now. Aram and Murad, they belonged to Armenian tribe. Armenian tribe was very poor after World War I, but they were very honest. What happened one day in this lesson which we are reading? Murad came on a beautiful white horse to Aram. Murad came on a beautiful white horse to Aram. When he came, it was the time of early morning. When Aram is the narrator of the story. When Aram, you can also pronounce it Aram. So when Aram saw Murad on a beautiful white horse, he could not believe his eyes. He rubbed his eyes to confirm whether he was dreaming. But so the reason behind not believing him when he saw him on the beautiful white horse, the reason behind it, that first of all, they were the victim of extreme poverty, so that is why they could not buy the horse. So from where Murad had got the horse? So this was the question. And other thing, they could not buy because they could not afford it to buy. The other thing is that they were honest. The whole tribe was known for their honesty since last 11 centuries. So they cannot, steal. So here Aram could not understand from where Murad had got the horse. So this is what he was wondering about. This is what he was thinking about. So finally, after they they had discussed finally. Aram concluded that yes, Moran had stolen that horse. They both went for horse riding. They were riding the horse. They were enjoying. Later, Murad said that he wanted to ride alone. The narrator was ready, but there was a condition. The narrator was ready, provided that Murad let him. Murad let him ride alone. So this was the agreement which took place between them. So Murad alone he enjoyed the riding of the horse, but when it came the turn of Aram, Aram could not do it, as Aram did not know how to operate a horse. So he fell off and horse ran away. Then both went for looking for the horse, and finally they got the horse. The horse was brought back. The horse was brought back by them. So what happened one day Murad's uncle Khosrow, he had to come the narrator's home, and on the same day one more Assyrian farmer came to narrator's home, whose name was John Biro. As we had already seen that Uncle Khosrow was in habit of saying, "It is no harm, pay no attention to it." So when John Biro came and he informed Uncle Khosrow that his horse had been stolen, so at this he replied that he should not pay any attention to it, as they had lost their homeland, but they were not crying. So John Biro should not cry for losing a horse. This is what discussed between them. So let's see what happened next in this lesson. Now we are going to read page number 7. Let us start from the last paragraph of page number 6. "Pay no attention to it, my uncle Khosrow wrote." So when John Biro informed Uncle Khosrow about his missing horse, then Uncle Khosrow said, "Pay no attention to it, my uncle Khosrow rode. I walked 10 miles to get here," John Biro said. So further John Biro said that because his horse was missing, someone had stolen his horse, so that is why he had to walk 10 miles to reach there. "You have legs," my uncle Khosrow shouted. Then his uncle Khosrow shouted that he was having legs, so he could come on foot. My left leg pains me, the farmer said. At this the farmer replied that farmer John Barrow, farmer John Barrow replied that his left leg pains him. Pay no attention to it, my uncle Khusro wrote. So uncle Khusro, every time he used to say, pay no attention to it, it is no harm. That is why once again he said, pay no attention to it, my uncle Khusro wrote. That horse cost me $60, the farmer said. So at this the farmer John Barrow said that horse costs him $60. I spit on money, my uncle Khusro said. His uncle Khusro said he spit on money. For him, money has no value. He got up and stalked out of the house, slamming the screen door. Having said so, Uncle Khusro stand up and he left the room by slamming the door. Then my mother explained, so when Uncle Khusro left, then the narrator's mother explained John Barrow. So by explaining, the narrator's mother said, he has a great heart. She said, it is simply that he is homesick and such a large man. Further he said, he is a good man, he is having good heart, he is a gentleman, but since he has lost his hometown, so his attitude has changed and he started behaving this way because he was a homesick and large man. The farmer went away and I ran over to my cousin Murad's house. Then after the farmer John Barrow had gone away, the narrator ran over to his cousin Murad's house. So after John Barrow had left, the narrator Aram, he went to Murad's place. The farmer went away and I ran over to my cousin Murad's house. So when the farmer had gone, the narrator Aram had went to Murad's house. He was sitting under a peach tree trying to repair the hurt wing of a young robin which could not fly. So when Aram reached Murad's house, he saw that he was sitting and he was repairing a robin's wing who could not fly. So informally he was giving the robin some medical treatment, informal medical treatment we can call it. He was talking to the bird. At the same time, Murad was talking to the bird. He said, what is it? Murad said, what is it? The farmer John Barrow, I said. So as Murad was talking to the bird Robin, whose wings he was repairing. But till that time, the narrator reached there, and the narrator answered the farmer John Barrow. He visited our house. He wants his horse. So he said that the farmer, now he was sure, he came to know that the horse belonged to John Barrow. That is why he said. Dear students, I just remembered the date is wrong. It should be 28. Okay. So when he reached, he saw him repairing the wings of the bird Robin. So he said that he informed him that John Barrow had come to his home and he wanted his horse. He wants his horse. You have had it a month. Further, he added that you have had the horse for a month. I want you to promise not to take it back until I learn to ride. He said, here, you must promise me you would not give back the horse. You could not give the horse back until I would learn to ride. It will take you a year to learn to ride, my cousin Murad said. The narrator said, don't return the horse until I would learn to ride. At this, when Aram said that, don't return the horse until I would learn to ride. At this, Murad replied that it would take more than a year to teach him to ride. We could keep the horse a year, I said. Then the narrator Aram said that they could keep the horse for 1 year. So as his keen desire was to learn riding the horse, so that is why he said that they should keep the horse for 1 year until they learn to ride the horse. My cousin Murad leaped to his feet. What? He roared. So at this, Murad jumped to his feet and said, and he roared, are you inviting a member of the Garoglanian family to steal? So he said, are you inviting a member to a Garoglanian family to steal? As the Garoglanian family was famous for their honesty, so that is why he said, are you inviting a member of Garoglanian family to steal? The horse must go back to its true owner. Further, he added that the horse must be returned to its true owner. When? I said. Then Aram asked, when the horse should be returned to its real owner? In 6 months at the latest, he said. He said they cannot keep the horse more than 6 months. So he said at the latest 6 months the horse should be returned to its real owner. He threw the bird into the air. After he had repaired the wings of Robin, he threw it into the air. The bird tried hard, almost fell twice, but at last flew away, high and straight. Finally he managed to fly high and straight. Early every morning for 2 weeks, my cousin Murad and I took the horse out of the barn of the deserted vineyard where we are hiding it and rode it. So for next 2 weeks, Murad and the narrator took the horse out of the barn, and they used to take it out of the barn, the deserted vineyard where they were hiding, and rode it. They took out the horse from its hiding place and they used to ride it. And every morning the horse, when it was my turn to ride alone, leapt over grape vines and small trees and threw me and ran away. So whenever it was the time for the narrator to ride, the horse did not allow him to ride. Nevertheless, I hoped in time to learn to ride the way my cousin Murad rode. So in spite of that, he was thinking that one day he would be able to ride like Murad. One morning on the way to Fetvazian's deserted vineyard, we ran into Farmer John Byrow, who was on his way to town. So one day when they were going to hide the horse in Fetvazian's deserted vineyard, they ran into the farmer John Byrow, who was on his way to town. "Let me do the talking." So my cousin Murad said, "Let me talk to the farmer. I have a way with farmer." So as when it comes for the horse, he said, "I have a way with farmers, a way with horses." Here he said, "I have a way with farmers." So the farmer studied the horse eagerly. So Farmer John Byrow, he was examining the horse eagerly, as he suspected that it might be his own horse. "Good morning, son of my friends," he said. "What is the name of your horse?" And he wished them good morning, and further he asked the name of their horse. "My heart," my cousin Murad said in Armenian. So he said in Armenian that the name of the horse was "My Heart." "A lovely name," John Byrow said, "for a lovely horse." So at this he said, "It's a lovely name for a lovely horse. I could swear it is the horse that was stolen from me many weeks ago." He said, "I swear this is the horse which was stolen from me many weeks ago. May I look into his mouth?" So further he wanted to be sure, so that is why he said whether he might look into the mouth of the horse. "Tooth for tooth," he said. I would swear it is my horse if I didn't know your parents. He said, I would have been sure if I was not knowing your parents. I have been sure that it is my horse if I would not be knowing your parents. The fame of your family for honesty is well known to me. Further, he said that the fame of the family regarding honesty was well known to him. Yet the horse is the twin of my horse. He said, yet the horse is the twin of my horse. A suspicious man would believe his eyes instead of his heart. Good day, my young friends. So finally he said, a suspicious man believe his eyes, not his heart. So having said so, he left. Good day, John Barrow, my cousin Murad said. Early the following morning, we took the horse to John Barrow's vineyard and put it in the barn. So early in the next morning, they took the horse, they decided to return the horse, and they took the horse to John Barrow's barn. The dogs followed us around without making a sound. So dogs followed the narrator as well as Murad when they were taking the horse to John Barrow's vineyard. The dogs, I whispered to my cousin Murad, I thought they would bark. So at this he said, the narrator got afraid and he said the dogs, and he was thinking that the dog might bark. They would add somebody else. So at this the narrator's cousin Murad said they would bark somebody else. I have a way with dogs. So once again here also he said he had a way with dogs. So he had a way with horses, he had a way with farmers. Now he said he had a way with dog. My cousin Murad put his arms around the horse, pressed his nose into the horse nose, patted it, and then we went away. So finally, after he had expressed his affection and love and affection to the horse, then he left the horse and went away. That afternoon, John Barrow came to our house in his surrey and showed my mother the horse that had been stolen and returned. So on that day, on the same day, John Barrow with his surrey, as he got the horse, so that is why with his surrey he came to the narrator's home and he showed the horse and surrey, and he was very happy. He informed the narrator's mother that the horse that had been stolen, now it had been returned. I do not know what to think, he said. The horse is stronger than ever. So he said, I have no words to praise the person who had stolen the horse. Now my horse was stronger than ever, better tempered too. I thank God. My uncle Khosrow, who was in the parlor, became irritated and shouted. So once again the narrator's uncle Khosrow, he lost his temper and he became out of control, and he shouted, quiet man, quiet. He shouted, quiet man, quiet. Your horse has been returned. Pay no attention to it. So once again the lesson ends with the statement of Uncle Khosrow, with the patent words of Uncle Khosrow, it is no harm, pay no attention to it. Okay dear students, so thus we have finish this lesson today. In my next video lesson, I'll explain poem 2 of Hornbill. So you keep completing your notebook and keep watching the video. So thank you for watching this video. See you tomorrow.